Hello everyone, this is Chris, and welcome back to another Seed Showcase. Except in today's Seed Showcase is actually a little bit different, because instead of me showing off a brand new type of Bedrock Edition seed, explain how good all the types of things are, I figured I would go back to the olden days of the console edition and bring forward one of my favorite seeds from there and actually show you some of the things which I really like about this seed. And spoilers, you might actually see a few things which have carried forward to even to today. And because most people won't actually have access to this one seed, think of it as more of an origin as to where I began looking for cool and exciting types of seeds. But yeah, in case you are lucky enough to actually experience this seed on the old console edition, then actually type in these bunch of numbers right here. Yeah, only about five numbers, which isn't too bad compared to some of the other types of seeds. Yeah, you type them all in right there, and you will spawn in right inside of this small little forest, which is kind of nice. It's not too big, it's not too hard to get out of. And the reason it's nice to get out of it quickly is because just over here, just by this huge, huge mountain, which is pretty cool, we'll come back to it a little bit later on. But yeah, if you come up right here, what you might actually notice is that inside of the mountain, just right here, is actually a mob spawner sitting just outside the cave, which is just in view distance of the one player. And it's actually a pretty decent spawner of being a zombie spawner. And yeah, again, it's not too hard to get into, and it's not too hard to take hold of. And you probably already noticed this, but just right at spawn, there's actually a woodland mansion. Now, mansions, especially on console edition, is very, very common. I mean, if you have any type of roof forest, you're almost guaranteed to have a woodland mansion. And this one is particularly special because not only is there one woodland mansion, but there's actually two, which spawns in essentially right on top of each other, because you can see the roof goes right down here. And if we hop our way down here, we could see we are inside one of them from the other one. And we could also see, like, there's the outer window from the inner one. And yeah, it's all sorts of strangeness right here, all sorts of weird types of spawning stuff right on top of each other and other things like that. I mean, you've probably seen broken structures spawn on top of each other, but I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like this, at least on Bedrock Edition, where things spawn in so strangely right on top of each other, like this one staircase right here. Things spawn in so strangely that they just essentially break it in so amazing and fun ways. One thing you'll notice from right here is that there's actually two villages within view distance of each other. And not only that, you might notice that there's actually also two desert temples that spawned basically right inside of these two villages. Now, these two villages, they are the classic style villages on Xbox One. They actually never got Village and Pillage. So yeah, we still have the old style villages right here, but still to have like a desert temple just spawning in right in the center of the village. Like, it just does not care where it spawns in. And hello, little villager. But yeah, it just does not bother or care about where it spawns in. And if we have a look at this second one, this one is actually a little bit more interesting than the first one, because this one in particular spawns inside of one of the old village houses. Unlike the first one where it actually spawned in a crop field, this one spawns inside a house. And if we break ourselves inside, you could see some very strange type things inside this house. I mean, I feel kind of sorry for the villager that has to live inside of that house. And if you've been watching any of my seed showcases from Bedrock Edition, then you might know that my favorite types of biomes to actually show off are the crazy terrain, the savanna plateaus, the mountain type things, and other things like that. Well, in this seed, there's actually a huge, absolutely huge, especially for a classic size world, savanna plateau biome, which sprawls across all the way over here. And to have something like this, especially again on an 800 by 800 style world, is crazy to think of, is crazy to see. And I don't know if it's just me, but The console edition sized mountains feel a little bit taller and a little bit bigger than the Bedrock ones. I think it's just me. It might be some other types of small difference between them, but still to have all these types of mountains sprawling across the area with these waterfalls, with these little rivers and lakes going around them and under them, and even having over at this mountain, even having the underneath style thing, which is basically an underground cave. And yeah, you're going to have to deal with quite a lot of mobs under here. But yeah, if this isn't proof to show that I am far in love with these types of biomes, and I seriously don't know what is. And it even links out to some desert with having some floating sand and other things. I never knew that, but yeah, very, very cool. Heading your way over here across this one Savannah Mountain, what you will actually notice is that there is a mesa biome, but not any type of mesa biome. Actually, one of the smallest types of mesa biomes I think I have ever seen inside of Console Edition. On Console Edition, there's a setting which would allow you to choose the biome scale, and yeah, I think out of all of them, this is easily the smallest type of mesa biome I think I have ever seen across console and Bedrock Edition, only being, what is this, about 50, maybe 100 blocks across. So yeah, very, very scarce in terms of the red sand, in terms of the terracotta. And it even has a little village which is right here. That's kind of neat, which even goes across some of the mesa. That's kind of nice. One thing I actually really like about this is that when you transfer a console edition world over to Bedrock Edition, you get this sort of border type thing where you can obviously see the console edition from the Bedrock Edition. And if you were to just load this up on Bedrock Edition, then yeah, you will actually get some pretty decent things itself, such as this one type of Savannah village, which is kind of sprawling across a tiny little Savannah mountain. So yeah, that's kind of cool. So if you were like actually just loading in this one seed yourself, then yeah, there is still some good things to be found. And it's also kind of weird seeing how it sort of merges on the new types of terrain. That's kind of weird. Heading your way from the backside of the Savannah Plateau, what you'll find is this one classic village. And this one is particularly noteworthy because you can see it actually sprawls across other types of biomes. And oh, look at that, it even has some new types of villages. That's kind of expected, actually. It'd be weird seeing the classic style villages inside of the classic style village, but yeah, that's kind of a neat thing to see. And finally, the last thing over here is this one desert village. Because the worlds were actually so small, they actually had to fit in so much more stuff inside of a little area, and this one even has a desert temple too. It's not quite inside of the village like the other ones, but it's close, and it even has a little old style blacksmith right here. So yeah, if you were ever playing this, like if you ever somehow managed to get this type of world, then you get this too. And in general, that's pretty much the majority of things that I can remember which was on this one seed. Obviously, if you're on PS4 edition, you'll see a couple other types of things, but in general, this is the types of things I have actually found inside this one seed, and hopefully you can see why I like certain things and why I don't like other types of things and why I prefer seeing other types of things in seeds and while not other types of things. But yeah, for now, that's pretty much all I have for you, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later.